a total of 150,000 people. So you don't tell me that you don't have to go around that now, right? In 1958, an American came to this island by the name of Ray Klein. And he goes to Bunny and said, we're going to the Klein, you know, Taiwan. Ray Klein was the new head of the CIA in Taiwan. After his 4 years in Taiwan, Ray Klein got promoted to be the deputy. After that, Ray Klein became the director of intelligence at the State Department. Ray Klein harmed the people of Taiwan for 10 years. So, Klein is the biggest in the year before Ray Klein came to Taiwan, in 1950, the mob that had been encouraged by the secret police. And say, ROC police stood by while the mob raided the embassy and stole American documents. A year later, President Eisenhower sent a letter to Chiang Kai-shek. Here's what President Eisenhower said to Chiang Kai-shek. This message bears my warm personal regards to a leader of outstanding valor and highest principle.
And
shame on President Eisenhower. In 1961, the CIA wrote another report for the president. The president was John Kennedy. Here's what the CIA told John Kennedy.
The CIA told Kennedy,
martial law and the most possible of security organizations operating under secrecy enable the regime to prevent a breakup of undesirable elements.
這個高陽啊,高陽這個地理片場交接號,是需要來進行來避免這個台灣的分裂。America
knew what was going on in Taiwan all along and did nothing.
其實這個政府比台灣這個大陣,一點都沒什麼清楚,可是我們不再去上面很高。
Then came the Vietnam War, and America's secret war in Cambodia, fought out of Taiwan. The planes that bombed Cambodia flew out of Taiwan.
不晓得这个王简的标狗吗？那个标狗呢？也没有这个，就这边不可惜了。
Now it's time for another trip to Washington. Jim Kinkow went and was entertained again in the White House by John Kennedy.
可是经过一个不失败遭遇，如果跑去见这个就跟赖北中共。
And once again he went to the CIA headquarters.
问你们是去拜访这个 CIA 中共。
And then he made a